One, two, three, walk on.
You ready? Say walk on.
Walk
on. Walk on.
Walk on. Walk on. That works too.
Walk on.
Walk on.
Evan has, he's always been very physically inclined despite his disabilities. And so we've always tried to seek out activities for him that he could enjoy. Being on the horse, you have to work a lot of your core and work on trunk control and balance. It was something that was very accessible for him to do outside in the country, enjoying nature. So horseback riding has been something that is a great physical exercise for him. It seems to be just the perfect thing for him.
He's been a lot more talkative and just happy. Like, it's nice to see her on a horse just having fun. She tends to get very frustrated and throw lots of temper tantrums because she can't tell us what she wants, because she's nonverbal, has a hard time walking on her own. So when she gets on a horse, it's like a completely different kid, and she gets to be so much more independent. And she gets to move like she doesn't normally get to move on her own.
It's a therapy in disguise. Some kids have talked more. They learn right rein, left rein, how to turn the horse, and it builds up their core. It's amazing that you'll see some of the kids walking like this, but as soon as they get on the horse, they're doing that. When we're on the horses, we're still doing the therapy. Kids in the wheelchairs can trot around the ring, and not only that, they're in a wheelchair and they're looking eye to eye to people instead of always looking up at them.
Wesley is probably our highest need student we have. He's only been here for one semester. This is his second semester. We're actually really excited to have him because he's one of the students that we actually get to work really hard with to get him to, I don't know, build up his muscles. It'll have the best benefit for him.
He's doing better this time than he's done before. He's stronger in his body, strength, core strength, I guess is what it is. And I'm sure he's glad to be here. It's hard to tell sometimes if he's
on the horse.
Excited or not, but he gives us good smiles and stuff.
He actually did a great job, was supporting himself pretty much the whole time. Seemed to enjoy it, and we got him to trot for a little while. We do about, you know, 5-6 sets of trot. So this time we did half of the long sides. For Wesley, I would like to see him building up his muscle and actually getting to ride without a vest at all. It's a high hope, but it's one of those things that we have 8 weeks. We can push it and see what we can do.
When you ride a horse, you have fun, and controlling a big animal like this is quite an accomplishment. So when you see the challenges that some of these people overcome, that just makes your heart go pitter-patter, because it's just amazing to see these kids and the smiles that they have.
I have two boys. They are blind. They began the horseback riding lesson for 3 years ago. Before the class, before the lesson, they did not understand because they cannot see how big, how small is the big. They have the big problem. But after this lesson, he began the speaking.
Can you say walk on?
Walk on.
Okay, good.
We use two languages, Korean and English. They had the language shock, but now they are fine. It's a big change.
Evan has what is called cerebellar hypoplasia. With his disabilities, the trunk control is really the big issue. Fine motor control, balance, coordination. And when Evan first started, I remember sitting in the stands and kind of holding my breath, particularly when they would start to trot, because Evan was kind of all over the place. I mean, his head was bouncing around. He would flop from left to right. And I thought, sure, he was going to fall off, but he never has. And I've just seen tremendous progress in his balance and also his ability to shift his weight. He's learned how to move with the horse, and that's been important for helping him develop a stride in his walk. One of my proudest moments was just a little while ago when I saw him walk up the ramp and get on the horse. That may not seem like a lot for many people, but Evan's been in a walker most of his life, and it's only recently that he's been able to walk without an assistive device. And to watch him go in the barn and get his horse and lead his horse out here and then walk up the ramp with nothing is just an incredible sight.
She has, it's called agenesis of the corpus callosum, which essentially is you have that big middle part of your brain that lets the two hemispheres communicate to each other. She doesn't have that. It's a huge range of outcomes for it, and it's just been a waiting game to see how she's going to develop. We've always had the attitude of she can do everything that everybody else can do. It just may take her a little longer. So, you know, we just kind of take it in stride for what it's worth. And if she ends up walking or talking or whatever, that's great. If not, you know, we take those little baby steps. We'll take what we can get.
Walk on.
Because of what she has, she's very low tone. So she can think what she wants, but then actually making it happen is hard. So when she gets on the horse, it stimulates those muscles that she can't necessarily stimulate herself. So it kind of wakes up everything and helps create pathways that aren't naturally there. Today was great because, you know, no one was holding on to her. She was on that horse holding on by herself, and I think it just helps create a good sense of independence for her. Our son does soccer and t-ball, and there's not a whole lot out there for kids with disabilities, so I wanted to have her to have something that was hers to do.
It's not therapy to them. It's something that they can look forward to all week. There is like physical therapy involved, but the mental and emotional therapy, I think, is even more important.
Eric has autism, and he has had significant issues and problems and development getting to where he is today.
Yeah.
I think any new skill that he can do is building his self-esteem. And I think often his self-esteem is very low because he knows that he can't do a lot of things or process things the way other people can. But here's a skill he's developing, and he can feel confidence, as well as the physical aspects of it. As he has maintained a physical activities, he has grown in the other areas as well.
Yeah.
She was a little fussy this morning. Hence, I think, why she was a little fussy on Maggie today. She wasn't having the best morning, but she seems to be in better mood now, which is good. That's why we do this. Not very often do I see her here in a bad mood. Whenever she's on the horse and the horse is moving, she's just as happy as can be. It's something about, I guess, the way the movement of the horse is. She really enjoys it. It changes her mood like that. So you can really see how being on the horse kind of mellows her out and gets her out of that funk that she tends to get in sometimes. Whether it's she gets to talk more or she starts walking better after she's done, it's just a really cool thing to watch when she's in the middle of the class and then when she gets done with the class, how you can see it carry over at home.
You're not going to talk kids into moving like parts of their body that they're not used to moving in a room in a physical therapy office. But when you incentivize it with a horse, it's really, really cool how effective this sort of therapy can be, and I don't think it's recognized enough.
You want to come say hi?
It's Maggie's who she rides. And every time I say, you ready to go see Maggie? Like, she gets this big grin on her face, and she just gets so excited, she starts kicking her feet.
You get on your horse?
It's amazing to watch how these children bond with the horse, and how the horse seems to bond with the child. David, they think, is completely blind. Charlie is the horse that he's ridden since he's been here. Without the visual piece, he's able to bond better with Charlie, I think, because he completely trusts him. For blind children, there has to be a huge component of trust with everything in their life. And the fact that he can't see and he trusts Charlie so much, they're like best friends. David is nonverbal, and instead of saying walk on, they've taught him to push Charlie on the neck as like a go button. And when he has to stop Charlie, he pushes the button on the neck as well.
Justin's probably been doing this for about 7 years. He had not been on a horse before, so it was all new for him. And he just kind of took a liking to hanging out with the horses most of all. Like, his favorite part of the program is probably getting off the horse and going in the barn and doing all the stuff, like putting the saddle up and brushing the horse and that type of thing.
Charlie. Uh-huh. Charlie. Uh-huh. Bob. Uh-huh.
And he's gotten to know all of them. I think he's ridden the vast majority of them in the barn, so since he's been here.
Shadow back in number.
Wow!
Yeah.
Wow!
Never?
He was tiny when he started, and he's taller than me now, so it's just amazing to watch how he's grown in every way.
Justin has been with us for so long, and he's just made like leaps and bounds every semester. It's amazing when you think, like, oh, it'll plateau now because he can't go anywhere else, but no.
He won a trophy at one of the horse shows that he did for most improved rider that year. He was just so excited, so the confidence level, and he is an outgoing person, but this is a place where he's just completely accepted, and he's had wonderful volunteers and developed a great relationship with Sarah, and so his relationships are even better.
It's great.
David is a much better judge of character than I ever could be, because he has to trust his instincts. So for him to actually find people that he's comfortable with and let them in is pretty big.
No, we can't get on now.
I started working in therapeutic riding because I wanted to be around horses more. And a week later, I was coming back because I wanted to be around the kids more. It's really fun, and it is a lot of work, and a lot of times it can be really emotional and really taxing, but I think the volunteers get as much out of this as the students do, if not more.
Do you know what color Bob was called?
I think the outreach part of it is so important, and that's so positive as well, to see just more inclusiveness and to see more understanding of kids with disabilities.
It's really kind of helped Perry come out of her shell with other people. She tends to get very attached. My husband and I do a lot with her, but it's nice to be able to see her interacting with other kids, but then also with, you know, the volunteers and that sort of stuff. So it's nice to be able to see her start to get an attachment or a relationship with somebody else outside of the family, because then hopefully as she gets older, it'll be easier for her to start building relationships with other people.
Jeff has really brought out a lot of good things in Evan, helping him grow into being a young man and being a great role model for Evan.
They have a little guy thing. Okay. They crack up. They don't good listen job. To me in the ring at all.
Say it loud for Sarah.
Jeff has a very nice, free spirit. He likes to joke a little bit, and Evan's always a happy kid who has a great sense of humor. And so while he's riding, it's not just all seriousness. There's a lot of fun and games going on.
I've been working with Evan for the past, 3-4 years, however long that is now. He's made a lot of progress for me this year I'm especially proud of him because I feel like he's come into his own, you know, personality as well as the ability to walk and the ability to kind of just do the 2-point on his own. And I think before too long he could ride without a sidewalker, which is my ultimate goal for him.
Early on, when he was just a few months old, he was referred to a pediatric neurologist who did a brain scan. And the pediatric neuroradiologist who looked at it said, well, he has a cerebellar hypoplasia, and this is a progressive disorder, and he'll be lucky to live to the age of 12. And I went home and did a lot of praying. Then we followed up with our pediatric neurologist, who was a brilliant man. And he basically said, no, that's not true. He does have a cerebellar hypoplasia. But he would predict that Evan would grow up to be a clumsy adult. There are forms of cerebellar hypoplasia that are progressive, but you also see a lot of cognitive disability with that, and Evan was much too alert and interactive, and so he really felt that this was not a progressive form. For a few years, you kind of keep both of those thoughts in the back of your mind and aren't really quite sure where you're headed. Evan has amazed all of us, and I think he will grow up to be a clumsy adult, but we're just happy for every day that we have with him.
Cool. Sounds good. There we go. Good job. What'd you do today?
We twatted and did the nautical court.
The picture that I took was taken at one of the horse shows, and it was actually him walking into the barn with his walker, and he's got ribbons on the back of this walker, and he's leading his horse with the walker. And it's one of my favorite pictures just because it says so much about being a champion. No matter what your disabilities are, you can still be a champion.
I think the biggest thing with Evan today is upgrading to a bigger horse. He really likes riding the bigger horses, and it's harder for him.
He's having fun today. I think he was really pleasantly surprised to see that he was riding Bob, which he's always viewed as a big horse.
It would be fun to ride, and I hope I ride him again.
Stick Bob.
You'll stick with Bob?
Years ago when Evan first started, he almost rode the way Wesley was riding, that you would have to almost hold Evan up, and we would have his two sidewalkers, and he would not be able to make it the full lesson. So that was our biggest goal years ago. And then slowly but surely we were able to take them up, you know. And now to be able to see him, number one, ride Bob, and being able to stand up straight and know what his balance is was just sensational.
One of the cool things about therapeutic riding is the movement of the horse uses the same muscles that you use when you're walking. So it like builds muscles without making you walk. So that's definitely something that Wesley could work towards. You know, once he works on building his trunk control, he's also working muscles that he could use when he walks. So he could work towards taking steps.
He's doing much better today. We were just noticing he's more strong today.
We decided to start him without a vest at all, which I know last week they decided to, you know, take it off partway through. This week was, let's just go without it. He was doing everything on his own, sitting up, right, no support really. It was a shorter lesson, about 25 minutes, but it was really good to see that progress and see that he can support himself now.
He is looking so much better. He's upright and smiling. Go, boy!
Good job, buddy! Yeah.
The coolest thing is when you have a lot of these students and you see them start going from three people helping them out to two people to one person or none. So those parents are like, we never thought that we could ever see this happen.
I only had one sidewalker and I liked it a lot because there weren't so many people crowding me.
We are extremely proud of him. I mean, we all love Evan.
It was very good. This is his goal that we're trying to achieve. to see him do that today was great.
Maybe it's me looking back and just wanting it to be the best semester ever, but I think it's been a really good semester for progress.
I remind them when we can start the horseback riding lesson again. They say, smile every day. They are happy now.
That's a happy place. Good day, God. Can't be in a bad mood to see somebody being, you know, having a wonderful, wonderful time.
It makes me want to cry every time. Oh, to watch her be so happy, it just makes me very happy.
Everybody that comes here, parents, kids, volunteers, everybody leaves here a different person. He'll be riding forever.